floods which are raging through northwestern Pakistan.
11 years old, trapped under the rubble of a house.
Disaster in Asia.
There are still between 1 and 2 million people homeless.
A raid of deadly tsunamis slammed into one country after another. The shores. Thousands dead.
It has become legendary, the Israeli medical unit.
The Israelis arrived here Friday night. By Saturday morning, they had set up a field hospital.
When we came to Haiti, because it was the very early phase of the disaster, we haven't seen any severe casualties because they died. We came there less than 4 days after the earthquake. They died. We haven't seen in Haiti any mildly injured victims. Because they were hungry. They went to eat. They had to help their families. So we saw only what we call moderately injured victims.
The first time I saw the clowns, I thought, what are they doing here?
It's not really something that you used to see. A medical clown in a hospital somewhere that all of the people are soldiers and commanders. You know, IDF clowning together, and it's become like a one unit.
There's doctors, nurses, there's paramedics, there's medics, there's clowns. We all work as one crew, one team. That's the Israeli army. That's Israel, actually.
They came to us and they introduced themselves, and you know, with us they were very a little serious because they told us they came to do their work, but with the children you saw how they gave them so much.
It was like it was a little bit like emergency clowns. You know, we went from one child to another child to another child to another father to another mother. They were all in trauma, and I came from a place that I wasn't in trauma, but I was with them in their like circle of trauma. I could a little bit take them outside.
It is a great, I would say, component in releasing stress, distress of the acute phase.
When a person is in a state of trauma or distress or pain, they're usually either too immersed in the situation or they are detached, they are too much outside of themselves and they disassociate.
The people there, they were all in shock. Their faces were like...
Before a few days they had a house, families, and now they don't have nothing. And we start to build something with them, with a lot of tools from the theater and clowning and from the imagination.
When you are in a situation of trauma or in a catastrophe like in Haiti, you always feel that this doesn't belong to reality. It's like, you know, this is not normal. The clown is not normal as well. So there is something about the clown that really makes you connect in these situations where things are out of order, that this is like the most out of order that it can get.
The clown role goes back to history. In a sense, he or she or the group of clowns create what I call an island of resiliency, because around them, suddenly people who have been out of a crisis, disaster, suddenly there is a small island of laughter, play, smiling, shouts and cries and being part of, I mean, something that is very active, whereas the rest of the situation is still, or the surrounding is still affected by everything that happened. And in that sense, they help that group to recreate what I call a sense of community.
The depths of the Indian Ocean have spawned a natural disaster enormous in scale. The devastation is so widespread, it's almost impossible to fully gauge tonight.
Obviously, we came there sometime after the tsunami, so obviously we met with survivors and victims, and mainly children and adolescents who were very hardly inflicted by the tsunami. Kids that lost not only their houses and their villages, but actually lost family members, parents. And thanks to the methods and the techniques of medical clowning, how they were able to play with this terrible disaster, how they were able to play with these hard memories and to turn them into a game and to turn them into something creative.
I'm standing at the entrance of the Barzilai Medical Center in Ashkelon. The fighting has been going on for 2 months. Ashkelon and the surrounding area have been targeted by dozens of rocket attacks. At the moment, there are more than 250 injured. The Barzilai Medical Center is situated only 12 kilometers from the border with Gaza Strip, which makes it the first hospital in case of an emergency for the entire area.
During the war, we were standing in the emergency room. So many missiles landed all around the city.
Most of the injured that arrived at our emergency room at that time of the war were under extreme stress.
During the war, they took a very major part in addressing the post-trauma children and adults. People that are affected from the rockets.
זה לוקח להם כמה שניות, הם צורכים, הם בהיסטריה, הם... אבל לאט לאט פתאום מסתכלים איזה איש משונה ככה עם אף אדום, ליצן, מה בדיוק, ואני מדבר איתם, וגורם להם להסתכל ולבדוק כל מיני קשקושים שאני עושה, וקסמים ודברים, ולאט לאט פתאום הם משנים פאזר.
I think most of the time we were working, we were trying, or we were... working spontaneously with what we know, and definitely helped the people who came, the injured people, and the staff.
It is not just about being funny. The fun or the humor element sometimes helps people to put things in proportions. When you see yourself in a situation and you can laugh about it, then in order to do that, you already have to take a step outside of the situation in order to laugh. So you disengage from the situation and you can see perspective.
By the fact that the clown makes something funny out of it, or exaggerating it, or being able to show a modeling of laughing on oneself, yes? Being able to look at things in an exaggerated, funny, or otherwise an optional way to look at the situation, it is a model to some clients to be able to step out of themselves and look at the problem as something from the outside, not from the inside, which helps a lot, this distancing.
Yes, we know that we are here in a very traumatic moment, but we do something good, because this is what we learn.
The Dream Doctor's work and knowledge that I received trained me to know how to work with the medical staff, and to know what to do with a child that is hurting very much in this moment.
This organization, the Dream Doctors, is striving to bring the natural qualities of clowning and medicine to a level that it will be a profession with methods, with theory, with practice, and with, I would say, academic horizon. That means that they know where they're going and who they are. Professionally.
Give a little bit of your love to me. I'll give a little bit of my love to you. There's so much that we need. So send me.
show you care.
The clown has the ability to connect with people who have another language. They come from another culture, because there is always, the clown does not belong to a culture.
Give a little bit, give a little bit of your time to me.
Even though they didn't speak in their language, you felt that they communicate with them.
They ask me, what clown do in a place like this? But they ask it with a very big smile. So I just look at them and say, I do this. And I point to the smile on the face.
Give a little bit of your love to me.
They will have a very, very significant impact on the community or on the group they come to work with.
Give a little bit of my life for you.
In this situation, the healthy mechanism that we use as imagination, the healthy use of imagination, gets blocked. So the clown is like an immediate reminder, because the clown as an archetype is a symbol of imagination. They immediately remind us that this possibility exists, that there's a link, there's a bridge between ourselves and a mechanism, a psychological mechanism that we all possess naturally, and the clown activates this part of our brain, this coping mechanism that we have.